So if you start your vehicle one day and this light comes on, that little light right there, I asked my wife what that looks like. She said it looks like an exclamation point with arms around it. It's actually your tire monitoring system. The system actually monitors how much air you have in your tires. And typically when that comes on, your tire pressure is low. So that being the case, 9 times out of 10, you can just check your tire pressure, put the correct amount of air in there, and that light should go off. If it's something else, if you fill up the tires to the specific amount of PSI and the light is still on, then you probably need to take it to a service center to have it checked out, because sometimes the monitors, there's wireless monitors inside the tire on the rim that that can go bad, and that will set this light as well. What happens is water gets into the tire and wipes out that sensor. Called the tire pressure monitoring system, TPMS. On most cars made in the USA, there's gonna be a sticker on the inside of the door jamb. It's right here on the inside of the door jamb, right here. You can see original tire size, 225, 55, 17. It shows you front and rear, and then what the spare should be as well. So looking down here, cold tire pressure inflation, cold tire inflation pressure. You're looking at 32 PSI for the front, 32 PSI for the rear, and then the spare tire should be at 60 PSI. So this is for when the tire is cold. First thing in the morning is when the tires will be cold. So let's go see if it's at the 32 PSI mark. Okay, so I'm attached to a air hose here. And right here, typically on these air chucks, you have a, an indicator of the PSI inside the tire. But this is a mechanic-based one, so I know that this monitor, this gauge has been taken care of. But typically at gas stations, those things are used and abused pretty roughly. So people just throw them and they reel up into that the water air pressure little station they have. And those gauges are probably not the most reliable just based on the abuse that they see. So it's best to go ahead, get your own tire pressure monitor. These, you can pick these up from anywhere, any parts house, any parts store, less than $4. So it's always a good idea to have your own tire pressure gauge and not rely on ones that you see at the gas station, at the air water stations that are free. So 32 PSI, we're at 30. So just come in here, push the dial indicator onto the stem. Make sure you don't hear any air leaks. Right there, you can see that's at 30. So I'll go ahead and connect the air chuck and fill it up to the proper amount, 32 PSI. Okay, so I'll go around with the gauge and the airline, the air chuck, and fill up all the tires to the correct amount, and then we'll go back on the inside and see if it shut off the tire pressure monitoring system light, or the exclamation with hands around it, as my wife would say. All four tires have been brought up. They were all low. Some of them were 27 PSI. Brought them up to the required amount. Now we'll go back on the inside and make sure that the light goes off. So we're back inside the vehicle. Let's fire it up. Make sure that the tire pressure monitoring system light has gone off. Yep, there you go. Tire pressure monitoring system light has gone off. The TPMS light is off. If you have found any of my videos helpful, please consider subscribing to Bundy's Garage. Questions, comments, concerns, you can always reach out to me at bundysgarage@gmail.com. You can follow me on Twitter at Bundy's Garage. And like always, I'll keep them rolling for you.